I remember distinctly very well that noong napag-usapan yung 200 billion ang bibigay ng Congress, sinabi ko sa Tagalog, although broken, because I really do not know how to talk well. It's a mixture of Visayan and Tagalog in Davao. Sinabi ko, wag na wag ninyong do not fuck up with this pera, because it's really a blood money now needed to keep the nation alive. So wala akong ano, I would listen to Secretary Duque, but I gave him the instruction, and I admit it in public now, being sabi ko sa kanya, do everything you can. Sabi niya, there's so many proposals, so I do not care. If it's not cheap, if it is expensive, just go ahead and do something about it. Kasi ipit na tayo dito. And those were the early days. I remember yung ipit ako, I was boxed in any corner. Sabi ko sa even the task force, please do something about it. And the task force is a task force. It's composed of many talents there. Kung ang otos nang galing sa akin, correct, tama yan. Ako ang nag-otos sa akin, sa sarili ko, na sabihin kay Duque na gawain mo. Ngayon, do not tarry, because sabi ko, there's no more room in the hospital. And alam mo, sa totoo lang, a pandemic is a pandemic. It occurs maybe every, I don't know. But noong panahon ng, well, that was the Spanish flu just before the First World War. Yung talagang maraming million ang namatay. But with the advances of science, it's because we were able to come up with the vaccine. Lahat, even the germs are still here. But they can no longer inflict damage on the next generation kasi nabakunahan na lahat. But to say na nawala, you know, you do not kill bacteria and viruses. They linger on for as long as mankind is in this planet. Hindi talaga nawawala yan. Sabihin mo yung diphtheria, well, hindi yan. A vaccine cannot kill. It's the body that provide the defense against those microbes. Ito ngayon, wala pang bakuna. So gusto ko lang malaman ng sambayan ng Pilipino na I take full responsibility ng utos ko na magdalian mo. Wala akong pakialam kung saan ka magkuha, magnakaw ka. And I remember saying it, I do not care whether you go and steal, borrow, or kill a person to get what needs to be done.
President, we would want to start with some explanation to be given by Yusek Lau on the purchase of PPEs and some medical equipment.
We have a mannequin there that is the complete set of the personal protective equipment for a medical personnel to wear.
Who's inside there? A woman?
No, mannequin po.
Oh, bakit may mannequin ako dito?
kulang lang po siya ng ano. Ano tawag doon? It lacks the face shield. It's 9-piece item. So we start with the most expensive part is the coverall. Yung parang may takip sa ulo.
Well, okay.
This is the coverall. It has a blue strip, which is very, this is one of the marks of a very expensive coverall protection gear. This is what we call as Ebola level. Ang Ebola level, it can actually stop even air transmissible viruses. Ano siya? It's lightweight and it's non-woven, may heat seal, even the soon portion is covered to make sure that pag nagkaroon tayo ng spill, air or liquid, hindi papasok sa balat or sa clothing ng mga doctors. So when you go international, lahat sila itong sinusuot. There's only one country who's not wearing this, it's Korea. Korea has the same item but no heat seal. That's why even yung Korea companies that's trying to provide supply sa Philippines, we cannot accept their item because it's not heat sealed. Now, the difference between heat sealed and not, it's almost 200 to 300 pesos. So, mahal kasi, we have a price from DTI. There's one company known as Conweb. They are producing PPEs locally that will start on June this year. So, we will be buying it at 850 kasi local. But the materials will still be imported from China. But this one, pag imported to, at least 1,100. That's the statement of Senator Lacson, yung 1,097. This is one. Kasi this is actually 1,100. So when you say, they say PPE, sa DOH, that's just the coverall. Now we have locally made items like this. Yung mga local kasi hindi siya medical grade. Tela ang gamit, fabric. So pag fabric, may tendency yun na papasok yung tubig. So hindi siya protective. It makes you feel secure, but it's not actually medically safe for you to wear.
So let me interrupt you.
Yes, sir.
So do not buy that kind of overall suit, that is a plastic one, that would place the health workers, even if there is just an iota of chance na buhay yan. Tama yan. Yun ang binili mo?
Yes po. This high grade po. Yes.
Tama yan. Wala problema.
There is a standard set by DOH and FDA. Ano po to? International standards. And we're following that. We don't go below. Kasi nga, the company can be sued. We can be sued.
I agree with you.
Next po, we have the goggles. Yung goggles natin, there are many types of goggles. When you... That goggles po, meron siyang butas but not direct. Pag direct kasi, pag may fluid, papasok siya. So may ventilation but it's called the ventilation na indirect kasi may valve. So air can come in to make sure you will not perspire. The goggles is anti-fog para hindi siya mag-fog. And at the same time, may ventilation so that there will be no moisture. So pag wala siyang ganun, ang tendency you sweat, magpuputi-puti. The next one is we have two types of mask pinapasuot natin sa kanila. Both. We have the N95 or the KN95 and we have the surgical mask.
Where is the other one?
Nandun po.
The other is a surgical.
The blue one is the surgical, the white one is the KN95.
Okay.
It's a standard set by DOH, double mask po dapat ang suotin. And after that, we have the lab gown. The lab gown is isolation level. So the coverall is protective level, even air and water, hindi makapasok. The lab gown is isolation level. It means pag nilagyan mo siya ng tubig, hindi papasok. Pag nilagyan mo ng pressure, saka tatagos yung tubig. So there are a lot of cheaper lab gowns, but they cannot pass kasi po pag nilagyan mo ng tubig, tatagos lang. So it makes you feel safe, but medically, if you're not aware, you are risking your life if you do that.
Okay, let me again, pardon. Sinong nagbigay ng specification?
DOH and FDA po.
Oh, okay. So it's more expensive?
Yes po, because it has to meet the standards. Ito po lahat naka-standardized. Even the gloves, sir, is non It's powder-free, textured, and either latex or nitrile. Hindi pwede yung PVC or other types kasi masyadong manipis and hindi medical grade. And ang advantage po lahat ng sinusuot ng mga doctors natin, kahit yung head cover and shoe cover, it does not promote growth of viruses and bacteria, which is very important. Kaya hindi po pwede yung reusable. May binibenta mga reusable sa market. They offer it to us, we send it to DOH, and ang risk kasi pag reusable, pag hindi siya maayos, pwede ka mag-contaminate. That's the explanation to us given by DOH. So it's high risk.
Again, I interrupt you. Do not ever do that.
Yes, sir.
You just throw it away.
Yes, sir.
If you place a person in jeopardy, he's working, lalo na yung mga doktor, they're fighting for life. Tapon mo na yan. That's the reason why we are spending money. And we will spend money. I said, we can always sell everything that we have. Tapon na ninyo yung, kasi I read.
Yes, sir.
So sa kanila, yung sabulo, goes into the trash can pagkatapos. Paghubad nila, tapon na sa trash can.
I just would like to provide you feedback that the director of UPPGH, Dr. Gap De Gaspi, had expressed to me that they're very, very satisfied with the quality and the level of protection that these PPEs provide their doctors. Kaya yung infection rate daw nila bumaba, Mr. President. So the same is true for all of our other hospitals who are now using this personal protective equipment. That's why I'd like to thank USEC Lloyd Lau for really ensuring that our healthcare workers, doctors and nurses are fully protected using the level 4 PPEs as we have specified.
Pag panahong ito, medyo some say na nag-flat na tayo. But ang problema, the number of cases is going high. Some 14,319. The only good thing there going in our favor was that the recovery rate is very high. 3,323 ang death, 5 lang, bago. Total of active cases, 10,000 lang. Ano ba talaga itong, are we on the second, third, fourth, or fifth wave? Or no wave at all?
Mr. President, we're actually on the first major wave, major po, of sustained community transmission. Yung pong nabanggit ko na second wave, and my assumption, my statement was based on the article that was published by Dr. John Wong of the Epimetrics. Dr. John Wong sits as one of the expert advisors of the Interagency Task Force on Emerging Infectious Disease. And to him, as an epidemiologist, a top epidemiologist, he considers that the three first cases in the Philippines, although imported, would represent a minor wave. Maliit na wave lang siya, sir. Tapos nagkaroon po tayo ng lull of about a month, the whole of February. And then March, nagkaroon po tayo ng mga umpisang reported cases.
Alam mo, huwag ka masyadong touchy sa issues because always there will be pro and cons. Pakinggan na lang natin because this is a democracy. Kaya lang, but democracy, there is the favor of attacks. Issues plus attacking the guy personally. Ganun. So, alam ko ikaw, you are hard-pressed. And I know your situation. You just tell us if that's the If that is the one that's in your the gray matter between your ears, eh, di sabihin mo, ano, ayaw ninyo maniwala, bahala kayo, basta ito yung akin. So that, maybe you should adopt that kind of attitude. So be it. If I committed the wrong, as long as there is no malice there, kaya ito ng expensive. Hearing out now ni Attorney Lau, eh, tama siya. And I would even caution, I said, do not recycle. Because recycle, you have to, yan ang ayaw ko, in recycling, you have to worry whether or not it will cause a new infection. And worse, it would affect the user. Ang user niyan, ang mga doktor. Ang akin lang dito is, I'm looking for, what I'm interested to know is that, is there graft and corruption there? Was dirty money changed hands? Kaya talagang, pagkaya na, wala na tayong pinag-usapan, talaga maghiwalay-hiwalay tayo. Pero kung sabi ka lang, nagkamali ka, as it is, yung sabi mahal-mahal ng ano, ito nga eh, panahon ng, I said, at the height of the contagion, wala naman akong narinig putang na gustong tumulong. Ngayon sa tayo, sabi, umabot sa akin, meron dito, meron doon. So, sabi ko, papunta, si Bong, papuntahin mo sila dito at dalhin nila yung produkto. Kaya para tawagin natin ang, sa ibigay natin sa Interagency Task Force. Wala naman. Let me ask you this very crucial question. I just want to be satisfied, really. Ano itong sinasabi nilang mas mura doon at itong ko, mag-asawang spouses ko or the dealers of itong yung nabili ninyo at mahal? Oh, is there really a price difference there or haka-haka lang nila yan?
I do not know these two personalities. Ito yeah. Pong ko. Somebody might know about this couple. Perhaps, I don't know if you said Lloyd.
Ito yung nagpabili.
Yes, Mr. President. They have offered to sell. They are owners of, I think, Omnibus. The company is known as Omnibus. They are
a manufacturing company.
No, they are the exclusive distributor of sunshine in the trading. Philippines. The first document that we have was a letter from them sent to the Secretary of DBM, Manuel Avisado, that was sent to PSDBM. Their offer of the automated extraction machine is at 4 million pesos. We also have an email from them offering the said item at 4,350,000, which Senator Lacson is claiming that if you buy it direct from Suncure, it's only at 1,750,000. As per record, Omnibus Biomedical Systems Incorporated offered it at 4,325,000, and Guidance Management Corporation sold it at 5,274,423. Filana Serve Incorporated at 7,740,000. These are all domestic corporations selling Suncure equipment in the Philippines. However, during the bid, they did not win because a foreign corporation from Hong Kong-based, which is also an exclusive distributor of Suncure in Hong Kong, sold it to us, yung mga kits. So, natalo po sila sa bidding, kaya hindi sila nanalo. But they are complaining, why are we not respecting their exclusive distributorship. I think this it was correct that it reached Suncure Corporation because we were discussing with Ambassador Wang through the Chief of Protocol, Robert Borge, complaining about these issues. The officers from Suncure actually went to the Philippines. I met them last Friday and also yesterday. We met them over lunch at DBM. And we personally requested that if they sell directly to the Philippines, and they're willing to forego of Omnibus, because they were actually negotiating that since they have relationship with Omnibus, can they use it as distributor, and they are willing to reduce the price. I think Omnibus is willing to reduce the price. But I made a statement, categorical express statement, that we are no longer willing to discuss with Sancho if they go through Omnibus, because they were given a chance before when the government really needed it, and they gave us a very high price and threw the ball to us that you can only deal with us because we're the exclusive distributor in the Philippines. So if we allow them to distribute now at a lower price, we're giving them a reward for what they have done before. Mm-hmm. Now that we can go direct to Sancho, we suggest that we bypass them. Because we can get it cheaper. Second, they should pay for what they have done before. Kasi we nagipit na gipit tayo, hindi tayo makalipad. Kasi may meron tayong mga restrictions and all. They're the only ones who are connected to Sancho, and they're selling it at least not less than double the price. And you cannot get it unless you pass through them. I think the same problem with the private sector.
Okay. Anybody else? Anybody would like to? Yes, Secretary Roque.
Yes, sir. Ang punto ko lang po, meron tayong existing law against profiteering defined as taking advantage of a national emergency, and there's also a provision in the Bayanihan Act. And I think from what we heard from at least Project ARC, no, this is very serious kasi nga the only source that we can get these PCR machineries and kit is from Sancho now, and there was really almost an attempt to blackmail us into buying something very expensive, no? And that's why I thought baka meron talagang basis para investigahan po itong kokopol ng NBI, no, for profiteering and hoarding under the the special law on anti-profiteering and under the Bayanihan Act. Thank you po.
Oh, sige, we'll act accordingly in the course of maybe we'd be able to give a statement to the public latest about 3 days. Nakatambak yung papel ko sa opisina. So that everything will be presented to the public in black and white with the corresponding explanations. And NBI should study the matter very, very carefully. Kasi alam mo, itong mga putang inang negosyanteng to, whether it's really an issue of humanity and the greed, yung hoarding, ano, you cannot, it's part of the business, ano, practices, which you may call not even obnoxious, it's repulsive to the human mind when you start to think about it. But let's look at it on what it is legally. Sans the maybe yung mga suspicion, whether it is like that. After all, it's not easy to, you know, charge a person. I still believe in the if the NBI has the probable cause, then go ahead. But I still believe in the what accruing to government people working. The presumption of regularity in the performance of their duties. Dito na naman tayo sa ano. It's a more serious problem coming up is the issue of the OFWs coming in. Sa pagkangayon, meron tayong 24,000 stranded in Manila. And they are stranded in the sense that they are not allowed or they cannot go home because the local governments are not accepting them. So Merong mga pronouncement na ang policy na they will not accept returning OFWs. Ang masama nito, kasi pag ganun ang behavior natin, Secretary Bello says that there are about 302 coming in a short while. And 302 and 62,000 are expected to arrive as soon as our airports are open. Not really confusion, but in the desire to protect their respective turf territories. Ganon man, and I can say that if that is the way they would handle it, like a somebody who's really a chieftain of a city or province during a pandemic time, okay yan. Pero alam mo, hindi naman lahat talaga nagkasakit. And it is very cruel, actually, to deny them to go home. Nandito yan sila sa hotel because they are not or they cannot go home. First, because of lack of money and resources. So I have instructed, was it last night, through Secretary Roque, that I am ordering the use of all government assets, whether it's really the air or the sea or the transportation owned by government, that they should be utilized in accepting and probably delivering them to their, if possible, delivering them to their homes, to their families. Na itong coming na 302 is a big worry. Now, yung 62 na dadating shortly, pag hindi ninyo tinanggap yan, magkagulo tayo ang Pilipinas. Now, let me be very clear. Let me talk about legality para wala tayong sakit ng loob. Nobody but nobody can really stifle the right of whether he is traveling and working outside and coming in, going home. Nagkaroon lang itong temporary an aberration in the movement of people because of the COVID. Ito ang sasabihin ko sa lahat. I said nobody but nobody. And only the national government can impose restrictions on travel because it is the only agency who can declare that there is an emergency of national interest. The issue is national interest, and that power to of declaration is not shared by anybody. It's a national government. Ngayon, may mga syudad na ayaw nilang tanggapin. You know, I'm ordering you to accept them. Open the gates of your territories and allow the people and allow the Filipino to travel wherever they want. Yung sequestration ng tao o lockdown should dovetail the national policy. Or better still, as not to confuse the people, you are not allowed to unilaterally declare na ganito, you are closing the entry, the egress and ingress ng tao. Mahirap yan. Magkagulo tayo, kanya-kanya kayong... So, if you want a measure to be implemented in your local government unit, ask permission from the task force. Because, alam mo, it involves many issues. One, in the name of humanity. Two, is the constitutional right. And ito yung pinakamabigat. It is the constitutional right of people to go home, to travel and go home. Do not impede it. Do not obstruct the movement of people because you run the risk of getting sued criminally. Yung ang agency, because it is the national government who declared there is a national emergency involving a pandemic, an issue of health, that power cannot be shared by anybody else. If you want, as an adjunct of government, maghingi ka ng permiso sa task force. They are the better position really to assess. Kawawa itong 24, so I'm ordering kasali na yung pera sa kung may naiwan pa sa 200 million, gastos yun rin ninyo yun para sa pag-uwi ng tao. Because the reason why they are here is connected with the issue of COVID. Nagsiuwian ito, diniport, kasi nga may pandemic involving the entire planet Earth. So the reason why they are deported or forced to go home is because of, maybe so as not to have a contagion involving a lot of in numbers. To contain it, ito yung mga tangang ating mga kababayan, pinapauwi. Tanggapin natin sila.
Sir, yung pong order ninyo na 24,000 OFWs, lahat po yan ay na-test natin using PCR at lahat po yan ay negative. Kung sakali lang po na may makakalusot na nawala yung kanyang result at siya ay dumating sa LGU ng walang papeles, ang advice po natin sa LGU, tanggapin ninyo at ilagay ninyo sa quarantine hanggang dumating yung kanyang result. Sapagkat yung pong 24,000 po yan ay tested negative po sa PCR.
Yeah. Doubly, more reason really po for not refusing to accept them. Kawawa naman. Alam mo, you know, ladies and gentlemen, if you're listening, but Pilipino to, kababayan natin, tanggapin ninyo and provide for sequestration houses if you want. Yung doon sila i-quarantine. Pero hati-hati tayo sa problema. Total, hindi naman kami nagkulang. Whatever you need, we provide. It's just a matter of time. You cannot service the entire 110 million Filipinos at once.
That's why I think it's ignorance only on the part of the LGUs. They don't understand, you know. So I think tama ho yung sinabi niyo, we should lecture to them. We should have seminars. I'm willing to give it even via Zoom, di ba? We're doing this anyway for LGUs. We can do it for them. We have to educate them.
Mr. President, 4,000 will be home to their own provinces by Thursday.
It behooves upon the DILG to really see to it that everybody is delivered and returned to their homes, sa pamilya nila. Noong panahon ng good time, we were experiencing the benefits of the dollar. It formed a big part of our GDP. GDP is simply income. Ang ibig sabihin ng GDP is income. Noong income na sa bansa natin, malaki because nandito ito mga OFW. Tapos ngayon, hindi natin tanggapin. Oh, what's the fuck? That's final. Mga mahal kong kababayan, ang gobyerno may proseso na pag-modified quarantine, may mga lugar, pati may mga tao na exempted na sila so they can work. Gaya ng construction, malayo-layo naman sila, hindi man dikit-dikit yan. Pero dahan-dahan yan. Pero ito lang ang pakiusap ko. As I said before, kayong maglabasa na, baski na hindi nga kayo pinapayagan, lumalabas na kayo eh. Hindi ko naman kayo madampot, pati yung mga bata ninyo kung isali ninyo. But ito ilagay ninyo sa ulo talaga ninyo. Ha? Sa conscious mind ninyo palagi. Ang COVID ho, nandito pa. And yung pagpalabas ng mga tao, hindi ibig sabihin na tapos na ang COVID. Nandito pa rin. So, kung gusto mong lumabas ngayon, sa ngayon, wala pang medisina, walang vaccine, at your own risk yan. Kung maglabas ka, sabihin mo, wala mangyari, magandang antibody ko, gano'n, okay. Pero pagdating sa panahon, at nag-delirium ka na, at ginamit na yung ventilator, yung ventilator is the last chapter sa hospital. May ikaw, may lagnat ka, tapos may oxygen. Pero pag ginamit na yung ventilator na yan, ibig sabihin yan, yun na yung maskara mo papuntang langit o saan. Bantay kayo dyan. Do not be reckless. That's the word. Huwag kayong masyadong pabaya na basta sinabi ko sa inyo, alcohol, hugas kamay, mask. Maglabas kayo, take all precautions para walang sisiyan. Gamit ka ng mask, gamit ka. Pag tinamaan ka pa rin, papanahon mo na. At saka, if you are not allowed to go out, especially yung bata, pero malapit na. By the grace of God, we will have the vaccine before the end of the year. So, mag-asa na lang tayo sa mga marunong at saka mayaman na mga bayan. They are feverishly working on it. Pag nandiyan na yan, ako na ang magsabi labas na, pag hindi ka lumabas, hilain kita sa labas, dito ka. Sige, pasyal na kayo. Kaya may bakuna na yan. Bakuna muna dahil tapos bahala na. But without the vaccine, it's really danger. It spells disaster. So, yun, mask, hugas kamay. Mga bata, wag muna. Yung opening ng classes, that's a very... I will not allow the opening of classes na magdikit-dikit yung mga bata. No? Bahala na hindi na makatapos. For this generation, wala na matapos na doktor pati engineer. Wala. Kasi hindi na wala ng aral. Laro na lang. Unless I am sure that they are really safe. It's useless to be talking about opening of classes. That's probably mine. Para sa akin, bakuna muna. Pag nandiyan ang bakuna, okay na. So, remember that. pati yung mga mayors, governors, kindly remember that they are Filipinos and that there's only one body, the government through the task force, who can make pronouncements about lockdowns, about quarantine or sequestration of whatever. Mahirap yan. Isa lang ang gobyerno. The national government makes the pronouncement. You just follow. And itong sabi nga ni General Anyo, ito, tinamaan rin ito ng COVID si General. Sabi niya, in 24, on his oath of being a public officer, when you talk about official matters in an official discussion, your word is always under oath. So, sabi ni John Anyo, safe yan. Pag magkamali, mag may reinfection then, we will act accordingly. But anyway, he's the one who would, i-husband niya yung diula setup. Maraming salamat sa inyong lahat.